Hello students, in this part we are going to learn about the wattless current. What is wattless current? Okay, if you will see that wattless means you can say that in which the power or the energy over the cycle, or we can say the power over the cycle is equals to zero. Okay, so that is what we called, that is wattless current. The current in which the AC circuit is said to be wattless if the average power consumed in the circuit is zero. So the power, or we can say the wattless current or the wattless power, is represented by P average is equals to Vrms into Irms cos phi. This is the expression which we are using for the wattless current. Basically, wattless current is called the ideal current, or the current in which we can consider that the components of your only the Irms of sin phi. Why it is so? Because if you will see that here the current and the voltage are in phase in the case of resistance, but in the case of capacitance and inductance we have seen they are out of phase from each other. So we can say that the here if we will see that Irms component with the sin phi is ideal or wattless current, because it does not contribute any power in the AC circuit. Why it is so? Because of the purely capacitive and inductive circuit. And here we can see that the voltage and the current is differ by the angle, that is called pi by 2. So we can say that the current over the circuit has no power. So that current is what we called as wattless current. Okay? Thank you. Now we are going to start with the problem. So what is the first problem says? That is, a light bulb is rated at 100 volt. They have given us one light bulb which is rated at 100 volt. So I can 100 watt, not sorry, volt. It will be rated at 100 watt. So I can say that P average will be 100 watt. For a 220 volt, they have given us the applied voltage, that is 220 volt. Supply, we have to calculate in this case the resistance of the bulb. First thing, we have to calculate resistance of the bulb. Okay, and the second thing, we have to calculate the peak voltage of the source, the peak voltage of the source. And the third one, the RMS root mean square value of the current through the bulb. These three things we have to calculate. We have only given P average and V average. So first thing, we are going to calculate the resistance of the bulb. You remember that what is the formula we are using? P is equals to Vrms upon R. This is the formula which we are going to use in this case. So what I can say, if you remember the formula, one more formula we have, that is R is equals to Vrms upon P of average. So what is the value of V? V value is 220 volt upon P average is 100 whole square. You will find out the resistance value as 484 ohm. This will be the value of the resistance we can find out from here. Okay, now the next question is, we have to find out the peak voltage of the source. What will be the maximum value of its voltage? So we know that how to find out the maximum. V naught will be under root of 2 into Vrms. Similarly, we are finding for the current. Yeah, the root mean square value of current and voltage. This will be the maximum. So root 2 into 220 volts. So this will be the answer for this given problem. Okay, now the third one is the RMS value of the current. So how I can find out RMS current value? So this is the formula, P average upon Vrms. So what is your P average? That is 100 upon 220. So you will get it 0.45 ampere. This is the answer for your RMS current. Okay, so this is the problem which we have seen, that is related to the power. Okay, now we are going to discuss the next problem. Now the second problem says, a capacitor and a resistor are connected in series. They have given us a capacitor, one capacitor they have given to us. Okay, and they have given us the resistance which is connected in series. Okay, this is your applied voltage, this is connected at series. Okay, so they have given us, that is when they have applied as AC source, if the potential difference across capacitor is 120 volt and across resistor is 90 volt respectively, and if the RMS current in the circuit, current they have given is RMS current in the circuit is 3 ampere, we have to calculate impedance means overall resistance and the power factor of the circuit. So how I am going to start with? I will start with the first problem. What is the first problem? We have to calculate its impedance. So we know that ERMS, or I can say that will be your VRMS, will be what? It will be V square RC plus V square of C, because this we have already seen, because we have the two potential, and here this will be the resultant of these two. So what it will be? 90 square plus of 120 square. So we have this as 2250. After that we will have 120 volt. We will have this as 120 volt. Now this will be the IRM voltage we have calculated. Why we have calculated voltage? Because we have to calculate its impedance. We know that impedance formula is VRMS upon IRMS. So we have this 150 upon 3 ampere. So we have its 50 ohm. Now the second one, power factor we have to find out. So we know that power factor is equals to cos phi is equals to VR upon ERMS. That will be what? 90 upon 150. That is equals to 0.6 watt. This will be your power factor. So this way we can solve all these things which is related to this, as we have already discussed all this. So I hope this is clear to you. Thank you.